with another video, and welcome to Let's Play The Walking Dead. So it is time for my decisions on who's getting the food. So here we go. An obvious first one. Come on, guys.
Here, Clem. You need something to eat.
Fuck. Oh, this sucks. What do I give her? Jerky, an apple, or crackers and cheese? Well, protein would be good.
Okay, a sundae would be better next time.
I'll keep that in mind.
If you have any more food, Duck is hungry too.
Yeah, why don't we go get some food?
Duck was gonna be my next guy.
Hey, Duck. How about a little food? Here.
Yeah! Oh man, I'm so hungry!
Okay, and the next person... Carly.
Want something to eat? Have an apple, Carly.
God, I used to eat an apple every morning with some granola and 6 almonds, and that wasn't enough even then. But you know what? Yes.
See, I don't know, man. I don't know. Keep the last piece of food for yourself or say fuck. These are hard decisions, man.
Some of these people have gone longer than me without food. They're the ones that need it.
I know, man. I know, Lee. I know.
Here.
I don't want anything from you.
Take it anyway. You need to eat.
This doesn't change anything.
Well, that's it.
Not such an easy job, is it?
I don't envy you. I don't know how you have the strength to do this every day.
I don't have a choice.
Lee. Kenny, I know I ran out of food before.
Hey, it was a tough choice, but you took care of the kids. That's what a real man does. I'm serious about that offer to come with us. You've more than earned a ride on the RV with me. Still, I guess some people aren't going to be happy with your choices.
You're out! What happened to my food?
There's none left.
You keep treating people like this, and your days in this group are numbered.
You're one to talk, old man.
Yeah? Well, I don't see you working on that wall.
Ken, Lee, come here, please.
He didn't make it, did he?
He lost too much blood.
God damn it. I'm getting sick of this shit.
Ken, come back. There's nothing...
Let him go, Kaja.
But...
He just needs time. It's been a rough morning.
That man you brought, I tried. But he was never going to survive.
Well, at least he's not our problem anymore.
What about the other kid?
The axe! Hurry!
Fucker!
Move! Move!
Shit! It's stuck!
You okay?
Yeah, thanks.
Why'd you bring him here in the first place, asshole?
Dad, calm down.
You're gonna get us all killed! Why didn't you tell us he was bitten?
What?
He was bitten, and you didn't say a goddamn word!
But he wasn't bitten, I swear!
Well, your not-bitten friend here came back to life and tried to kill my wife!
What? Wait, you all don't know?
What the hell are you talking about?
It's not the bite that does it. You come back no matter how you die. If you don't destroy the brain, that's just what happens. It's gonna happen to all of us.
We're all infected? Everyone?
I guess so. I don't know. All I know is that I've seen people turn who I know were never bitten. When I first saw it happen, we were all hiding out in a gym and everybody thought we were finally safe. But one of the girls, Jenny Pitcher, I think, I guess she couldn't take it. She took some pills. A lot of them. Someone went in the girls' room the next morning and... God.
Back off!
Whoa, lady, relax! Me and my brother, we just want to know if y'all can help us out.
I said back off!
Carly.
Are you armed?
Yeah, for protection. Dead could be anywhere.
But, I think you got the upper hand here.
Why do you need gas?
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm a few miles up the road. If y'all be willing to lower your guns, we can talk about some kind of trade.
How y'all doing on food? We got plenty at the dairy.
Lee, why don't you and Mark check the place out? See if it's legit.
I'm going with you. I got your back if anything seems fishy.
So, what are y'all thinking?
You've got a deal. We'll bring some gas to your dairy. In exchange, you give us some food to bring back. We'll see how it goes from there.
Sounds fair. A couple gallons should power one of our generators for a while.
So, this dairy, you guys really have food?
Sure do. We lost most of the cattle, but we still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
It's nice to get away from that motel for a while. This Lily Kenny thing is starting to get ridiculous. Personally, I'd be happier if you started to take charge more.
You think they'd want me for a leader?
Sure. Everybody looks up to you.
Well, not everyone thinks I'm so trustworthy.
Because of your past. Does anyone else know?
Larry knows.
Great. That can't be easy.
Clementine might know. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore and asked me about it. I lied to her, but...
What exactly did happen with the senator?
Hang on.
It was an accident. I mean, I pretty much knew about the affair. Sometimes I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
Not sure everyone would see it that way.
Maybe you're right. Listen, over the years, I've reported on some pretty messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did.
Yay, Carly.
Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
I grew up in Macon.
Right here in the heart of Georgia. That's what I like to hear. Y'all seem pretty settled in at that motor inn. Who's running things over there?
It's a democracy.
We work as a group. All of us looking out for each other.
I hear that. There's so many dumbasses out there fighting each other these days. It's just stupid.
How many people you got over there anyway?
Nine, including the kids.
You forgot Ben.
Me?
That makes it 10.
Well, we'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great.
Everything helps. Nice.
Mama's been running the dairy for, well, as long as I can remember, but now it's getting...
You think you're going to cut me out of this?
Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always pulling this shit.
Bandits? Who? Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Who are they?
Fuck you! You knew we were hungry, and you guys were keeping it all
for
yourself.
There's only two of them.
Oh no, there's a lot more.
Yeah, and you know what? We ate it all. What are you gonna fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens, but let's just wait this out and hope they move on.
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you!
Jesus!
Asshole.
Holy fuck.
The world out here has gone to shit. Come on, let's get to the dairy where it's safe.
You fucking... That guy's gonna come back to life.
Here it is. St. John Family Dairy. Y'all can see how we kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
This is a really brilliant setup.
Suits us just fine.
This place looks untouched. You'd never know the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting. Hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He's from Macon.
A couple of our old farmhands were from Macon. They grow them good there.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh my goodness, that place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group?
We work together.
We work together. Plus, we've got plenty of people with military experience.
Well, that's good to hear. That motel ain't the safest place. Now that y'all are here, we'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
Does that offer apply to the rest of us?
We're all incredibly hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she...
We have a vet. We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet? Oh, my! Our prayers have been answered!
Maybe our whole group could come, for the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'd be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Take this. Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence? Oh man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
Before we can think about bringing our whole group here to stay, we need to figure out if this place is as safe as they're telling us.
Right. Obviously, they think it's safe. But is it safe enough for the kids? I noticed a broken swing over there. Not a big deal, but maybe there's other things not working that we just can't see yet.
And checking the fence perimeter sounds like a decent way to get a good look at their defenses.
All right, I'll keep my eyes open, and you find out what you can from Andy.
Cool, cool. Whew, man, this game is intense, guys, I tells ya. So I hope you guys are enjoying the series. I've been having to make some tough choices, but, you know, that stuff happens. So, but... until next time. So next time is going to be video 250. I'm thinking of doing some type of special thing. I don't know what to do. I'll probably just play a game for like a couple hours and post it on YouTube. Well, obviously on YouTube, but you know what I'm saying. I'll probably do a couple hour video. I don't know. There's nothing super special I can think of. But except for that. So I think that's what we're gonna do. So until then, so that'll be tomorrow. Actually, that will not be tomorrow. That'll be Sunday, cause tomorrow I work until, well, that might be tomorrow, cause I work till 11 on Sunday, or it's Saturday tomorrow. I work till 11 tomorrow, so I don't know if I'll be getting a video done by tomorrow, but we'll see what happens. So sometime this weekend for sure, obviously. But until then, guys, this is Swedish Ninja Fish signing out. Peace out, guys.